How many of you woke up today and went, I wonder how all of my psychotropics manipulate serotonin receptors? And it looks like this, right? So your atypicals, they're all very different in what switches they can turn on and off, which receptors they turn off. But the atypicals, look at the gold arrows. Look at all the serotonin receptors they can touch. Your serotonin partial agonist reuptake inhibitors, vordioxetine, valazdone, vordioxetine in particular. Look at all the darker orange arrows. It reaches out and touches a lot of receptors. Your sedating antidepressants, the blue arrow, the yellow. Buspirone, the purple arrow. We've had that one since the 90s, right? FDA approved for generalized anxiety disorder. It reaches out and partially agonizes serotonin 1A. We have a new antidepressant, gepirone, does this too, right? Buspirone, gepirone. So we could add that one here too. So our drugs are messy. They do several different things depending which one you pick. And how many of you have a brain scanner in your office? So when a patient walks in, you scan their brain and you're told, that's a serotonin 1A receptor problem and a 1BD problem. I have one of those in my office. Don't you have one? Yeah, it's all the stuff from this talk. I can't really tell, but if I try a drug manipulating those two receptors and the patient's depression doesn't get better, maybe I want to try some different receptors. Let's move to a new paradigm. I didn't fix this person with the first set of switches I turned on and off in the brain. Let's try some different switches and go for it with a different type of med. And so I kind of call that pharmacodynamic profiling. It's theory of practice. I can't show you the research studies that says this is better than anything else, but if something's broke and it doesn't work, why do we keep using broken stuff? Keep switching the paradigm. Go after a new set of switches.